Hey guys, what's up? Synergy here, and we're going to be bringing you a brand new tutorial, and this is going to be the hard raid on Destiny at present. So what we're going to do is we're going to get into the first part. Now I hope you all appreciate this, because this took me a hell of a long time to make for you guys, and there's parts in it where I specifically put when things have gone wrong, just to show you how you can get through that, and give you a little bit of tips and tricks really. Right, so as you see, we've got two Praetorians at the back of us. One of them is going to go to the centre, of which you need to call out for that centre just so they're aware of it coming up. And we're going to take out the shitty little lads just with our normal guns. Like so. Now there's two different spawn points on the left hand side. One is the cave, right in front of me right there. And the other spawn point is going to be at the bottom there, just on the grass. As you can see, one is spawning in right now, and I believe it's a Praetorian. One rocket will get it down pretty hard, but as you can see, it was down, but then it regened health. So you need to be careful of that. That's one of the main things you need to look out for, is just that Praetorian is definitely dead, and it's not like a walking zombie. Right, so this part is very simplistic for you guys. You're going to have two people at each podium. You're going to give each other call outs when you see the Praetorians, and they're going to be taken down fast. Now, as you can see here, we're not having many spawns right now, and the idea of this is to raise the spire, so you do need somebody in the circle. You can actually go out of the circle as long as it's up. Now you can see, there we go. Now this is an example of the Praetorian's health, so I'll super him, pretty much dead, and then he's suddenly alive again. Right, so there we go, we've raised the spire, so we are going to be moving on to the next point, guys. So what I've done in this video is I've created yet a full hard raid tutorial, so I'm going to show you exactly what to do, exactly what not to do and stuff like that. Now you can see my little bike skills right there. Praetorian knocked me over, so I'm pretty much going to get revenge on that guy. Come here, you son of a bitch. Who do you think you're knocking over on their bike? So now we've aggroed him, rocket to your face, monster, and you're down. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to go through here on our bike. Now this bike is very fun to use as well. It's actually the reward at the end on hard. V2O Timebreaker or something like that. And basically once you get through this cave, you'll see the actual chest just there. Just in front of the chest where the toilet was, you can edge yourself off, and that is the original path to the Templar. It's a lot of fun. I will bring that in another video, but for the purpose of this video, I will make it way too long if I include that. So the next part, we are moving on to the confluxes. What you're going to have to start with is you're going to have defend the central conflux. So what you're going to have is you're going to have, say, three people defending centre, two people defending left, one person defending right, and then obviously the centre can support right if needed. Because right is going to get your least spawns. Now, just to explain for you guys, you can actually save a bit of ammo here if you do have a fusion rifle. Just waste your fusion rifle ammo, rather than anything else. You want to keep a good amount of rockets on you for as long as possible, and what you're going to do is you're going to end up synthing, but you're going to synth at specific times. Don't just synth willy-nilly. Now, as soon as it summons its legions, what we're going to end up doing, this is a tactic that will work well for you, as long as you get into position nice and fast. There's no sort of waiting around or anything like that. You can see we've got a few fanatics coming. Your main problem here while you're defending the center complex is gonna be hobgoblins, because hobgoblins can snipe you down, as you well know. So that's why I've just regen my health there, not being stupid. I'm not poking my head out while I've got a third of health, and just having a little look around. and we're just going to take them out. Right, we are on to the legions. You're going to see exactly what we're doing. You need to watch out for that green goop on the floor. Jump over the fanatics, guys. Don't go close to them because they can explode on you and take you out. So we're just not going to rush into it. We're going to let people get in there. You can see Stone Stealth struggling a little bit there, but he does make it in anyway. Right, so that's the first part down, guys. Now all you need to do now is you need to relax, have a chat about what you're going to be doing, who's going to be going where, and what they're going to be doing, what their job is. Just make sure everybody's in the know, because communication is a key factor in the hard raid. Now what I'm actually going to be doing is I'm going to be defending the left conflux, and you're going to see my exact position. Because I'm in the left, I'm going to let these guys get out first, because I don't need to get out that quick. So that allows them to get in position a lot quicker. Now you can see where Relentless Shine is at the back of the conflux. He's just going to be watching any of those back spawns there for me, just in case. We got one that's sacrificing there. We can waste our normal ammo just when it's like one or two sacrificing, for example. But what we're going to do is when it does get a bit hectic, like so, we're just going to place a rocket down and we're going to take him out. It works exactly the same for the right hand side. Basically what you do on the right hand side, you have one guy behind the conflux poking his head right, and in other words shifting to his right, shifting back, shifting to his right. The other guy is going to be behind the wall on the left hand side, because he can't be shot from the left. He's going to be giving rocket cover. Now his rockets are going to be basically clearing it out whenever it gets a little bit messy. The only one thing you need to watch out for behind that wall is a Minotaur just coming round the wall and then ground smashing you. So just be careful of that, you can easily avoid him. One of the other tips that I'm going to give you throughout this, guys, is you're going to see it through the video, so I'm sort of going to tell you that as and when it comes. So obviously we're defending the left at the moment. We've got our middle defenders, we've got 2, 2 and 2. Now you can, if you have a good player with a lot of rockets, you can solo this left hand side. So if you feel that, say, one of your sides may be just a little bit weaker, you can actually place somebody else there as extra support. So they can be given support, for example, to the right hand side, as well as the centre. At the moment we're only on the two confluxes, so it's just right and left. Now this is the harder part, so if you get past this part, guys, you've done very well. Right, so as you can see, I'm just letting one sacrifice, letting the other get close, and my rocket's going to take out a lot of players there. Well, not a lot of players, you know what I mean. Right, so we're back onto legions. Some people are coming up onto the top. I'm just going to check my ammo synth. I'm going to use my synth right when the legions start. The reason I use it straight away here is because the countdown will start ticking, which means we're going to be waiting here for a while, so that's going to half my synth time, which will allow me to synth once I've run out of rockets. And I'm actually in Nova, I'm a warlock by the way, and because I'm in Nova I'm also able to plant a Nova bomb down there. Because of my position, I don't need to be in Sunsinger, as in I don't need the self revive, because I'm not going to die here. It's very, very easy to stay alive. It's just don't be overconfident and don't be overly stupid with just say, oh, ammo pack on the ground, let's go grab it. Next thing you've got, a Minotaur in your face. And not from outer space. Right, so I'm going to waste some of my normal ammo in here, because my normal ammo isn't actually necessary for this left hand side. Rockets are your best friend. It's the same with the central, the same with the right. And obviously different classes have different super abilities, and they're obviously going to help you to take those ads out. And you can see I'm just taking a few out there, but now I'm just going to get my eyes back on that conflux, because what can happen is they can come from the center and they can actually teleport down to the conflux, so you just want to be careful of that in specific. And you can see there's a hobgoblin in the centre. If you do get some hobgoblins and you've got a rocket spur, obviously you can just throw that rocket straight at the hobgoblin and just save anyone from getting sniped. Now, unfortunately, I had to reload my rocket launcher there, so we are going to have a sacrifice. What you don't need to do is, if you have one or two sacrifices per podium, you don't need to worry about it. It's not the end of the world, and you're not game over. You've got at least four sacrifices that you can have. Now, bearing that in mind, if you're very hit hard, and you've had hardly any sacrifices, just let one or two sacrifice. Regen your health. Because you're going to be better off alive than dead. Now, I do need to cough a little minute. Sorry about that. Right, and I'm just going to place some more rockets down. So this is the three confluxes. You can see the spread on the map where people are. For the central conflux, you do want one person watching behind the conflux for anything that teleports behind. The other guy is basically going to wipe out the centre as much as possible. Now you can see Relentless Shine is actually giving me cover from that place up there. So he's going to be taking a lot of fire, so when he needs to regen, he's going to move off that part. But he's using that conflux as a secondary barrier shield. So the conflux is actually protecting him from the incoming fire. Right, so we are back onto Legions, and you're going to see my team coming over here now. One of my teammates asked me to make a formal apology in this film, because you're going to see exactly what happens to him. I shift to my left, he rockets me in the back, and he kills himself. And personally, I was laughing my tits off. Okay, so when you're up here, you do want to be careful of one thing. See that sniper right there that just sniped me? Right in the corner, right at the top. Just be careful he doesn't kill you and take you down. Now, this is just all about surviving the wave. So, everybody's in the loot cave, everybody's on top, so everybody's going to survive. Now, the next part, what you want to do is you're going to be doing a full-on wipe, but before you do the full-on wipe, what you need to do is you need to wait for the oracles to spawn properly, and you need to take one of the oracles out. I take a second one out just to be certain, and I'd advise doing the same anyway, just in case. Now, you're going to see exactly where they spawn. Now, interestingly enough, you can actually kill some oracles as they're showing them to you, which will make them a lot easier. However, it doesn't really make a difference. But just to show you that you can kill the oracle, there you go, Hunter and a Warlock, take that one out. And what we're going to do is we're going to show you that one more time, when it spawns. There it is. And there you go, oracle taken out. Now that's only showing us the oracles, by the way. Now it's the proper oracle part. So we take out oracle again. And obviously you can see my teammates have already begun to wipe, so what I did is I was having a little bit of fun with this. I just want to show you a little bit of survivability. Now you can see I'm hit down pretty hard. Look at this. Let's have a little bit of fun. Okay, so we got a Minotaur over here. We got some goblins. We're just going to jump over using the glide. Now, eventually I am going to kill myself because it's not fair to keep my teammates waiting, but I did want a little bit of fun, so I thought this was a little bit of fun for me. And yeah, it was just funny, really. Okay, so I'm going to go into the loot cave, regen my health, then I'm going to kill myself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump forward and we're going to create a wipe. Right. So this will give me a little bit of time to explain for you guys. We are now moving into the Oracle stage. Now the Oracle tactic that you're going to be using is a lot different to what many people will be using at the moment. I'm going to show you everyone's position. You want your two weakest snipers on the left hand side. By weakest, it doesn't mean the players are weak, but they've got the weakest snipers, as in they're not fully upgraded, for example. It doesn't make a difference. And also, a good scout rifle will help you out a little bit here. You can see Tyler. Tyler's going to be on the top, where you can see bottom right, center, top right, and you can also see center right as well. Likewise for Lemon Towel, who's going to be down in this position, and he can see bottom right, center, and center right, and top right. Okay. The one I couldn't be asked really jumping up to was Toilet, and he can basically see all of the above, including the left hand side, so we can offer some support if needed. Now what we're going to do is we're going to have one person. You need your agility higher to make this jump, and you just jump over here. Now you can see that the event hasn't started, it's because I've not touched the ground. Next, you're going to jump over to this platform, and once you're on this platform, you're just going to jump up, get over here. Now if you look down, that's where you're going to be jumping on to get back up. So all you need to do is come onto the ground to start the event to begin with, and get up there as fast as you can. So we're just going to show you. Jump, glide, jump and glide onto this ledge, and then we're going to jump and glide out and in just to make sure we get on. Now you can see the position that I'm taking up at the minute. This is going to get the one oracle that can't be seen by everybody up the top side. One of the things I will say about being in this position is if the Templar is at the right hand side of you, you're going to see this a little bit later on, like so. You can see him there. If you shoot, he will aggro. So he will shoot you. He can't do much damage to you, and you can escape pretty easily. We're just going to show you a nice little escape route. Right, so for the oracles, we do have quite a few to get through. Now, when you're on this side, once you've killed your oracle, you can actually support the others, and we're going to show you exactly how to do so. By supporting, you can help to cover the center one, and also the bottom right. The left one's a little bit tricky for you, so you won't really be able to get that one. And there we go, we're just going to take that oracle out. Doesn't really matter what guns you use as long as the oracle gets taken down. And likewise is exactly what my teammates are doing at the minute. Like I said guys, this is 40 minute video, so it is a full tutorial for you. There's parts that I've cut down just so the video isn't ridiculous in size. But what you can do throughout the video is you can actually skip to the parts that you may be struggling with in specific if it's not the whole raid. Right, so we got wave number 2. There's my oracle. So this is exactly what you'll be doing, whoever gets assigned this position in your teams. At the moment, this is Dark Mash the Clan. Now my mouth will be getting a hell of a lot dry throughout this. You imagine commentating a video for 40 minutes, guys, it's a lot of work. Not only that, you've got to create the video, you've got to put all the different segments in, then you've got to upload and everything, and yeah, it's just a bit of a ball ache. People say editors don't do much work, but they actually do. So I have to disagree. Okay, so my oracle will be coming up in a second. There we go. Okay, so we've took my oracle down. Now, just to point out, if you are a warlock, what you need to be is you need to be in Sunsinger mode, and you need to get your supercharger, so Sunsinger straight away to begin with. Obviously, it's not good pulling a hunter in this position because he can fail that jump a hell of a lot. Now with the Sunsinger, there's three different perks that you need to have on. One is going to be your standard AoE grenade. The other one is the extra grenade. You also want Song of Flame on. Song of Flame basically reduces the cooldowns for nearby allies. So what that's going to do is it's going to allow warlocks that say, for example, aren't supered up, they can actually throw nades continuously as long as they're pretty close to you. Now, the other one that you want on is what we call Radiant Will. Radiant Will is just going to increase the duration of Radiance, which means you'll be able to throw a lot more nades a lot longer. And we're going to show you. Basically, to get your fifth chest, they've actually incorporated it, and I believe they've actually meant to do this, so you basically cheese it. So, as soon as these oracles are over, we will talk you through the next part. So in the next part, you're going to have one person who's going to be carrying the shield. Their sole job is going to be killing ads, and whatever super they use it on oracles. Do not hit the boss with a super, whatever you do. If you hit the boss with one single super, you won't get that fifth chest. Now, just to explain it before we get into it, you're going to have two on the left hand side who are going to cover those oracles and kill as many ads as possible. You're going to have three on the right hand side to cover the three oracles that spawn at the right, which is top right, centre right and bottom right. Now, what your warlocks are going to be doing is you're going to be using those AoE grenades to direct the boss directly up the stairs. If you throw it too far on the left side when he's going up the stairs, he can shift over to the left hand side and he can be in a very awkward position, which you won't be able to push him off the edge. Now don't worry guys, you're going to see exactly what I do and how I do it. You can do it with only one warlock in your raid, by the way, so if you've only got one warlock, don't worry about it. As long as that warlock knows exactly what he's doing and how to do it, and he doesn't die, you will be fine. If you've got three warlocks in your raid, I won't lie to you, it's going to be a hell of a lot faster, which you're going to see throughout this one, because we actually do have three warlocks. One warlock can do this without it reaching the end rage timer. I have done that. I will bring that in a later video just to show you as well. I'll also bring you all the flawless different segment parts and show you those. Right, so there we go. Oracle's part is over. So what we're going to do is we're going to move on to the next part. But just for the fun of it, just before we do, I'm going to show you exactly how to get back over to them. Just over here. Straight up. Turn around. Up onto here. Straight up again. Just normal jump will do. You can go from this bottom one, it's not a worry. So we're going to come over here, do a little dance, shake a little booty, and get down to night. Boom, shakalaka. And then we're just going to try and push him off the edge because we're a dick. Unfortunately, they don't fall for it. Right, so we're moving straight into the next part. You can see that's the beginning, so I've just double naded him, which is going to push him back, and then I'm focusing directly straight on the oracles. I've got some heavy rockets, which I'm going to use on these oracles, which I'm going to use on the Harpy Disciples. Now, in your Sun Singer, when you do melee these Harpies, it takes off half of the health, so just bear that in mind. Your Sun Singer is very strong against it. And you can see I've nearly got another nade ready. The main thing that you want to worry about here is if you throw a nade when he's doing Ritual of Negation, he's going to have like a little flame above him, and your nades are not going to push him back while he's doing that, so you need to throw your nades when he's not doing that, as in when he's on his normal shield. So you can see, if you are a warlock, you're just going to help. You can see Lemon Towel's using his super there, that's why I'm not using mine yet. And he's just going to direct him back as much as possible. Now you can see he moves back a little bit there. We've got some more oracles that are spawning. And that one's been taken out at the top right already. Not going to throw that rocket there because that will undoubtedly create a splashback effect and kill me. Okay, so I'm just going to use the rockets to take these oracles out nice and fast because I've got nothing else to use the rockets on. So there we go, two rockets down. That's going to allow me to push up to the boss now. Now you're going to see exactly how I direct him. You can see him going back there, and there's another person with nades as well. Now he's preparing the ritual of negation, so I'm not using my super just yet. You've got to time it right, guys. Just going to help to take out some of these here. Now you can actually take out the oracle right at the side of you there if it does spawn for these guys on the left, just to help them out. Right, so now I'm going to super and I'm going to spam the boss with my nades. You can see he's slightly over on the right hand side from where I'm facing. You don't want that, so if you throw your nade slightly on the other side just to make sure he's going back to that ledge. And you can see I'm almost down there. Just regen my health and throw two more nades. There's one. And one more nade. This should do it. Oh, wait, we've already done it. Okay, so that is as simple as that, guys. What that's going to get you is it's going to get you your fifth chest, of which is coming up in a second. Right, so we're going to show you the way down to the fifth chest. This is from the Spirit Balloon Cave. And I always get lost here. But here we go. Now the one thing about this, guys, if you do die in these jumps, you can respawn at certain points, but once you get to the very, very, very bottom, you can't respawn, which means you'll miss your chest if you do die. So just be careful of that, don't be overly confident. Right, so what we're doing here is we're just showing you the route down to your fifth chest. If you don't know the route already, this will help you. Hi-ho, hi-ho, down the caves we go. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I just felt like I needed to say something. And eventually, once you do get down to that fifth chest, I've just shown you though, without hitting my glide, how much damage a short jump can actually do while you're doing that. You just come through this gap, and there you go. Bang! Fifth chest. Right, so once we've looted this chest, we're going to take you to the next chest. There we go, you can see only one person got an Ascendant Shard, two people actually. So a lot of us have already done this hard raid, but we're doing this solely for the video purposes and the people who's left to do it as well. Because we're a big clan, so we've got a lot of people that we do need to take through the raid and stuff like that. And here's going to be your next chest, right there. Right, so what we're going to do is we are going to move on and we're going to show you the Gorgon's Lair path. Now on hard, in the hard raid, the Gorgon's Lair path is a little bit different for you. So you need to be careful, first of all. Now we're going to show you from my perspective, so I'm going to be going first. Now this is the way that you're going to be coming. Just wait for that Gorgon, you see him there? On the right hand side, wait for him to pass. You can see he's coming towards you, just back off. You've got no reason to move forward. Okay, no double jumps, guys. That is mainly, don't shoot because you'll alert them. This is a mistake that a lot of people do make. Now we're going to do is we're going to wait. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and now we're going to move. That allows us not to be seen. And then we're going to move up the hill. You don't need to jump. You can actually use this as a straight path up. You can see Tarlet, unfortunately, is getting in my way a little bit. Now there's a Gorgon down to that left hand side, you need to wait for him to move. The one on the right hand side is not going to see yet as long as you don't double jump. So just drop down, move straight forward. Now the way that you're going to do this is you're going to be careful, keep an eye on that minimap. That'll allow you to know where the Gorgons are. And you can see everybody's getting a little bit thirsty to go first. But we're just going to go straight diagonal forward and through here. That's going to bring us to the path. Now there's several different ways of doing the path. If you're a warlock in specific, you can make it in one jump. But what I like to do is I like to use two of the stairs in order to get there, because it's just a bit more fun. And you're going to see how I do that without taking much damage. So stairs number one. And then number two, we're going to try and get onto the top. We do get knocked a bit there, so we get a little bit fortunate. Just going to use one glide and then one more glide around about here. And that's going to drop us down when that runs out, and you can see hardly any health lost. And everybody has made it nice and safe. Okay, watch out for that little rock there on the left hand side, it will slide you off. The next part, what you want to be careful of, and this is just to show you, different classes will get across this different ways. There's a little bit there that you need to jump over. If you don't, it will just slide you off as well. So that's going to be that part, guys. Next, we are going to be moving on to the double relics. As you can see, the screen's going black at the minute. Right. Now, the main thing you don't want to do to your team here is to just be overly aggressive, run in there, and then get sniped by a hobgoblin. Because I will tell you, people will get annoyed with you if you keep dying at this point, because it's very hard to actually die at this point. Well, it's not very hard, but it's very easy to mess up. So first of all, this is the tactic that we're going to be using for the double relics. If you are hit like I just got, for example, you need to get in cover and just make sure you've got enough health not to be sniped completely down. That gatekeeper's going to end up dying shortly anyway. I've got four rockets, and the person coming in with me has got a full synth of rockets. I'm not actually synthing, because four rockets is plenty for me. Now, in the first relic room, there's going to be one person holding the gate open, the rest are going to be defending outside of the gate, and two people are going to be going in, which is going to be me and a hunter, which is me and Stone Stealth. Now in the first relic room, what we're going to do is we're going to take the boss down as fast as physically possible. You're going to get 2 minotaurs in that room, of which they can melee you pretty damn hard and they can shoot you down. Now for some reason, even though I'm supered, I seem to lose my super when I go into this room, so it sort of cheats me out of that one and I'm unable to self revive, so if I die, I die. What we are going to show you as well is we're going to show you the part where only 2 people stay alive at the very end part of this. There you go, 2 rockets straight into the boss. We're going to fire a 3rd rocket just to make sure he goes down, and my teammate's going to sort that out. Now, we're being careful of where these minotaurs are. There you go, it's exploded, so the relic will spawn now. It does bug out a bit, so make sure you get it, like so. I had to do that. I did take a big hit there, but I'm already on my way out. Stealth has just dropped a load of orbs for me, which allows me to be supered. Now, you're going to stay still. The guy with the relic is going to throw a quick cleanse. You're going to move over to this right hand side. Take down any ads while again the gate's open. Just help your teammates out. The less ads you take out, the harder it's going to be on the people who are defending it. And you can see 2 people are down, so you do need to provide them that help. At the moment, this is showing you from a perspective of where it goes wrong. Rather than show you a flawless run, I'd rather show you how to complete it if you've only got certain people up. So we've got 4 people up in total. Fire a super straight at the boss, ground slam, and just take out the ad so he doesn't take your teammate out. And you can see I'm actually hit pretty hard. I'm going to cleanse here. He's going to keep running up, grab the relic. Now I'm supered again. Now I'm going to cleanse here. And as he walks through, he's completely cleansed. And we're just going to move straight on the outside, just like we did in the first relic room, guys. Going to cleanse straight on the outside. And this is where everyone's going to move to the centre, and there's only two of us left. So, if this does happen to you guys, don't panic. Have teamwork, and just basically be amazing together. So we're going to take out these normal ads, because the minotaurs ain't going to spawn. You can see I'm pretty much hit hard. So we're going to have minotaurs coming from the centre, and the two portals, of which me and Stone Stealth are going to be working together, just to secure that as long as possible. Now as long as you get this done, you get it done. So this is from a two-player perspective. You can see we've got Sacrifice in here. Try to hit him. Unfortunately, you can't really do it without supering him. You can super the minotaurs as well, so just be wary of that. You can see I get hit down pretty damn hard, or I end up getting one of my abilities to regen health. And me and Stealth are basically double teaming exactly the same minotaurs so we can reduce the amount that do sacrifice in one. And we're just going to try and knock them off there, and there you go, we survive it. Okay, so, sorry about that. What we're doing is we are moving on to the Oracle Room now. Now, in the Oracle Room, it's very handy to have at least one hunter in there with the Golden Gun, because the Golden Gun is basically going to allow you to get three Oracles down, and it's going to preserve a lot of ammo for the other person who's in the Oracle Room. The Relic Holder doesn't exactly need to be the best Relic Holder in the world. Now you can see we actually use a level 29 Relic Holder, and we're using Galahorns, and we're just going to plant face palm straight into there, and you can see the relic holder has nothing left to do, so therefore he is safe. So we're going to take out these oracles now. You can see this golden gun going to work, and Stone Stealth is destroying those. One that plants right here to your left, and when you've done this a few times, you'll start getting in a rhythm. What you want to do at the end of the oracle is kill this one, get your cleanse. Have two of them go out, and one person kills this. What that will give you is it will give you more time in order to damage the boss. So you can see now I'm completely black screen. Don't panic when it's a black screen. Use your glide, but the way you can direct it is if you see all the green names, that's exactly what you're aiming for. Don't just run forward, glide. Glide in the air, you'll make it. It's as simple as that, so in other words, don't panic. What one person can do is they can actually help to take out some supplicants on the outside if your teammates, say, maybe are struggling to do so. And I'm going to be using the super. I'm actually in Nova as a warlock, so it's very handy to have a warlock in Nova through these rooms. Because what you can do is you can actually take out all three hobgoblins with the split projectiles. So in other words, your Nova bonds split into three, and therefore they cover a larger area, but also each one does the same amount of damage. So you can see here, we're just going to continue this, and then we're going to go out. Now, the one thing I forgot to point out is don't use the centre ledge, which most people will do. If you use this back ledge, you will not get any splash damage whatsoever. Now, you can see where Connor sat just above my gun. You need one person sat there. If you don't have that person sat there, those supplicants will come into your circle and they will take you out. So if your guy dies up there, I'm afraid you're practically screwed unless the boss is nearly dead. Right, so you're going to see man over bomb, 1, 2, 3, perfect hits, and we'll just finish that last goblin off. So you want to give your relic holder as less of a job to do as possible if you are on the oracle room. Now I'm going to let you know of a little hint as well within this, how you can actually damage the boss a lot quicker. And say if you're a Galahorn, say if you have a Galahorn, this was actually figured out by one of my teammates, this. If you have a Galahorn and you're in the circle, what you can do is you can jump up, you can shoot the boss. Obviously, make sure you jump up out of the circle. If you plant a Galahorn in the boss, hopefully I might show you in a minute, you're basically going to do, what, 12k damage, something like that? So you're going to do a hell of a lot with a fully upgraded rocket launcher. Like so, boom, you can see the rocket. Look at all that damage that that is doing right there. And we just managed to plant one before we ended up in the next oracle room. So the next route he should be down. I'm just moving back here just so I don't get sniped. You've got to be careful. We're going to help that relic holder down. Unfortunately, this one didn't go as smooth. But don't worry, if you've got a good relic holder as well, you can survive. As long as he ground slams them out. Right, so we're going to reload. Now, everything that's in our ammo pack, we are going to plant onto this boss this time, because we're going to take him down. And so concludes the full tutorial of the hard raid for you guys. Don't forget, if this tutorial helped yet, throw a subscribe down. Every little subscriber helps. I'll be bringing you on daily content as well. I'll be bringing you very good videos. And yeah, I just hope you enjoy my content. And there we go. You can see we've just finished. Somebody did get Aspect of Glass. A lot of people haven't got rewards because we've already done it. And we're taking other people through it because we are a big clan. Right. For now, guys, peace out.